This isn't some guide or tutorial video, but a feedback on something I wanted to discuss for years now, but I was always forgetting it. So, I'm going to try on Silverblue Rawhide and see what happens. So first the boot starts, and then we get that screen. That screen is from Plymouth application, and it is supposed to do three things. 1. To get rid of the flickering during startup. 2. To hide information that we don't really need to see. And 3. To look pretty. But what really does, is the following three things. 1. It makes startup slower. 2. It hides messages we want to see. 3. It camouflages the sweetest screen of Linux ever, kernel's loading screen. So basically someone is working and puts effort to make things worse, and then the distro vendors, almost all distro vendors, implement this application for a god knows why. And yes, I know we can hit escape to escape it, but what's the point of that? Normally we can simply remove Plymouth, but that won't really work in Silverblue, and besides we may just want to keep the package but just disable it. What we can do, is to open kernel arguments editor that's basically the grub entries, and edit the boot parameters. From a Fedora guy blog, I read that would be enough to set our d.plymouth and plymouth.enable to 0, but on my testing that would only gives us a blank screen. So the next I'm going to do here is to remove quiet flag, which it will make it work, but it will also force more messages, so it is not a quite nice solution. But as I told you in the beginning, this isn't really a tutorial, and personally I'm just removing Plymouth all the way. Saving this file will also force Silverblue to automatically generate a new initramfs image, so when the deployment finishes we can immediately reboot. And of course now we get that screen and we're waiting like idiots having no idea what's happening. But if we hit escape everything will be more clear. And now we can finally boot with the original Linux boot screen everyone loves. There's some more logging that should be, so we didn't learn how to do it properly, but at least we learned what the quiet flag was doing. But the real question is, do you prefer a stupid graphical bootloader, or the original Linux thing?